go soon.
Yeah, it looks like we should be good to go in a second. All
right, we are counting down.
Yep, so our racers are going to be off and running any second here. Amak going to be off a little bit before Plectro. Amak always has, like, the greatest skins for Cadence.
It's a pretty good one.
Yeah, they're always great.
Do they make skins?
I'm not too sure. I believe so. I believe they make their skins. Nothing's going to top the angry Facebook face for me. ever.
I don't remember that one.
Oh, it was just perfect. It was just this. It is just the angry emote from Facebook, but specifically Facebook's one. And I'm sure in that set, Amak got like two gigantism scrolls, so just this huge angry face appeared, and it was a good time.
That's great. Oh, I do. Yeah, I remember that. I remember when it was the gigantism version.
Yes.
Yeah. I do not agree with Plectro's Bloodshop decision there though. Like, I think they did probably the opposite thing of what they should have done. You have a Bloodshop with Illuminati Torch, Gold Spear, and Dove Charm. And they took Gold Spear, like, fine. But, like, I don't think you take those two without taking Dove Charm, at the very least.
I think in Blood Tier, we're going to be pretty hard-pressed to see them take the Dove Charm. They, like, even I'm sometimes so, like, should I? Probably.
I think I think that's, like, if that's the mentality of Blood Tier racers, that's totally wrong. It does mess you up sometimes, but it means nothing can ever stand in that tile, right?
Like, this is true.
No enemy. It's one quarter of your possible. Well, I guess 1/8 of your possible directions to get hit by. It's just permanently safe. Except for jumping into stuff. But that's your, you know, that's within your control, right? You don't have to, like, it's not like, oh, I'm not paying attention to this side while dealing with something else and something hit me. It's like, yeah. So I get it in terms of the, like, upset expectations, but it's so good.
Yeah, Dove Charm, it is really good. It's really powerful. On that note, down Dove for life, just, you know, as an aside.
Yeah, I think I agree. Electro going to skip the ring. Probably shaky about their health.
I imagine so, yeah. Would have been down to half a heart. Going to buy the Circlet of Telepathy and the Holy Water here. So a bit of mapping
okay
from
with
that
it,
Circlet.
Take the dang ring. Like, if you have the Holy Water. Take the ring, heal up on, you know, on your Zone 2 Mushrooms or something. Or on your boss. Right?
Yeah.
Like, this is a perfect boss to get a full Holy Water heal on.
Exactly, yeah. It's exactly what you would have been looking for. I think, like you said, once you find that Holy Water, you can take take that Ring of Pain.
They use it for the quick kill anyway, right? So,
which is just surprising when, you know, 6 bombs could have been up to full health here at the start of this 2-1. But alas, not the way it's going to go. I did notice in the black chest on the boss, it was an obsidian cat. Amak did pass that up.
Did Amak get anything from the boss?
He went black and skipped the obsidian cat.
Wait, what? Okay. You know, if you're not comfortable with it, like, that's fine.
Yeah, but if you're not comfortable with it, then don't run it. But my advice would be get comfortable with it as soon as you possibly can.
Absolutely.
Because it's such an incredible weapon.
I disagree, Rivalize. I think, like, you just need to learn to get good with things.
There is a point when that becomes the case. Yeah, at some point you just gotta start learning stuff.
And I can see the argument for, like, okay, this is a promotion race, just do what you're comfortable with, play your game. But, like, that will, like, if you let yourself do that too much, I think you will be a worse racer as a result.
Yeah, you'll stagnate because you're not pushing yourself.
Yeah. I can see the argument. That said, I think a lot of people who become really good do so because they push themselves in these, you know, like they know that Dove is the right decision, even if they're not comfortable with it. And this is like, it's a great opportunity to learn when you're trying your best, right? Like, this is one of the best opportunities you have to learn.
Exactly. Like, that's the thing. This is the environment in which you're practicing to be better in. So there comes a point where you need to be trying things in these conditions to improve as a racer. Because there's only so much you can do. You know, you can run as much unseeded practice or Necrobot races as you want, but it's not quite the same as doing it on the big stage.
And I do agree with Panda about, you know, like, cut him some slack, it's blood. That's totally fair. That said, like, you know, there's definitely a happy medium between, you know, don't poop on people and, like, give people useful suggestions to improve.
Yeah, exactly. Like, just to be clear, neither myself nor Will, and I don't think anyone in chat either, is slating the decisions here. Ultimately, the feedback and the commentary we're providing is to help these racers improve, because if we turn around and say, you know, not taking Dove, perfect decision, that's bad commentary, because the Dove is good. You know,
right. And I mean, even, you know, you and I had like some disagreements on whether it should be taken here.
Exactly, yeah. No one
the
is here.
The thing that's
to...
really confusing about the radio in my headphones is that sometimes it appears to be different languages.
Do you
like
just
right now?
You just live in some kind of mecca.
Yeah, I don't understand what's happening with it, but like right now it's just like Eastern European sounding language. I'm like, what? Like, I'm in LA. Like, why is this happening to me?
Plectro is from Eastern Europe. Could be that. Could just be influenced by the racers at the time.
Yeah, that's true. My magical headphones of weird radio interference.
I mean, they're already doing some weird stuff. It wouldn't surprise me if they were taking yet another step.
That's true. Into, like, actual magic. Yeah.
Alright, so both of our racers down onto Zone 3 here. Both of them trucking on through. Not running the build ideally you want. Still on this gold spear, which isn't ideal.
Yeah, and I'm not getting pretty close to losing that potion.
Yeah, needs to kind of scoot around the sides of these skeleton knights.
Yeah, and he really wants to open that crate down there and that red chest with spiked ears. You take him over. Yeah, I think you take him over, Miner's Cap.
Yeah. Oh, Plectro has Wonder.
Holy cow.
Plectro has a Ring of totally Wonder and is going to grab the Blast Helm. Yes, absolutely. So now running a 3 damage gold spear. In fact, no, sorry, running the dagger of Frost. Go get the Obs Long. No, go get the Obs Long.
Definitely get the Obsidian Long.
All right, that is one of these decisions that is straight up wrong. You grab the Obsidian Long. You have Ring of Wonder, so it's +2
in,
damage.
In blood, I think
it's
you absolutely do
it's
that.
2 range. It's you got it.
I can see the argument for piercing in a higher division race because it's just incredibly valuable. For Blade Masters and Skeleton. You know, you already have the damage, right?
Exactly. It's not going to make the difference at this level. It's kind of the key factor. Stay away from that jaw.
Yeah.
Alright, smartly done. Just to wait on that goblin coming over.
One thing I've noticed with Plectro is they like waiting out enemies coming to them, which I think is a pretty... standard. And Amok gets Wonder too. Was it like just in a shop next to a scroll of Transmute or something?
I assume
they both have Wonder.
So it's...
Have we ever had a race in Condor where both racers get Wonder? We've had a lot where one person gets it.
I'm not sure. This could be the first one.
Man, are... that green sprite is great.
That is somewhat horrifying, but a pretty good signifier. Okay, I have glass armor.
Transmog Scroll and Ring was there. Okay.
All right, okay.
That's why they both have Wonder.
Yeah.
And why we missed it happening, because it was just instant.
Exactly. Just happened. No kind of ceremony about it. You'd have to go into the transmog.
Yeah, they actually were never on becoming at any point.
Exactly.
Oh man, that okay. I think it absolutely is wrong. This butt axe, though. I'll say that.
I think you have an argument
for Ring of Frost, but I don't think you have an argument over Blood Axe.
No, not with Ring of Wonder. You're doubly, you have it's three damage. It's you're not only regening off of the floor, but yeah, on the weapon, the kills. I think
now
what
it's
we
Japanese
what
in the headset, but...
We need to get you some new headphones.
We'll
skim a little bit off of the top of the prize money for season 5.
Let's not do that. I have a ton of regular nice headphones. I just don't have any regular. I don't have any nice headphones with microphones.
Ah, I see.
That's the issue.
All right, Plectro going to spend the bomb and get into the food shop here.
Which is absolutely the right decision.
And it's going to fireball
as
well.
This race is fairly close.
Yeah, they are. They're
on the same floor.
Yeah, they're on the same room, essentially. Plectro does have it cleared, but he's going to go over and check the shop. Check this purple chest. What is it? Courage? No. No, thank you. Don't want anything to do with that.
Can't tell if Amok is trying to get into this food shop. I think you probably don't. In his position, you have basically chainmail. You have Ring of Wonder. You have regen forever, basically. And you're behind. Oh, that map on Plectro's side.
Yeah, gonna do him a couple of favors here.
I think it's missing. No, I think you definitely still check for spell, especially Plectro being a little bit ahead. That said, I don't think it was necessarily the right decision to check that shop in the first place. But once you're checking it, you might as well check.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Right. Because that's the other thing with Wonder, too, is that it has the cooldown reduction rather than the extra spells.
All right. Well handled Kara Rift for Plectro. Manages to get the Frost Dagger kill off. So pretty swish from them. Gonna go purple. They're just... Please get off of this Frost Dagger. Please.
That's another, I think, incorrect. Gotta check black.
Yeah, you gotta find anything with two range.
And that's, I think, the biggest, thing that a lot of people know. Like, with, people, in lower tier of blood, it's just the, basic enemy handling that's an issue, but with sort of higher tier blood racers, it's really the decision making that's a problem, which I think is what we're seeing with Plectro now.
Yeah, because we've seen Plectro take care of swathes of enemies without too much issue. But some of these decisions are a little bit confusing.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you have that Blood Axe right now, you're probably, you could be another floor ahead easily. But instead, it's a closer race than you'd probably like position.
Yeah, really not separated by all that much. Plectro going to jump down on a 5-3, a Mac not far behind. So it's likely going to come down to Deadringer and the Necrodancer more than anything else.
Yeah, it's fair to say, the Frost Dagger over Blood Axe choice is better than the Gold Spear over Blood Axe.
Yes. Ooh, good use of that Earth Spell right at the last second for Plectro. But it cost them a lot of time dealing with this room, so Mac is going to have another good chance to close this gap even more.
Electro backing up, or sorry, Amok just backing up too much there. You can really clear, like, you can push forward with that setup. It was a little spooky, but it wasn't deadly by any means.
Exactly.
That's kind of the other thing that you see, like, as sort of an issue sometimes, is just, honestly, you see this all the way up through Obsidian, is misjudging what is like a deadly situation that you cannot push into, and what is a safe situation that you can go fast.
Yeah, and it's tricky. It's really tricky.
On racing. Yeah,
because you got to hand. You're just having to track so many enemies that have different amounts of health. They do different amounts of damage. A lot of them have different. They move on different numbers of beats. They move in different ways. You know, it's a lot to think about at once.
Yeah, but the only way to get there is to practice pushing rather than practicing
exactly.
Going.
But with all that said and done, Plectro is going to go
Plectro
up.
Plectro taking it.
Yep, going to go up 1-0. So GG's to him. Had a really, really nice Earth kill on Deadringer as well. Which is, I will scream it from now until the end of season 6. Learn your dead ringers, and that's how you do a dead ringer, using the tools you have in the best possible way. But GG's to Plectro, like we said, 1-0 leading the set, looking to get themselves promoted into Titanium for the end of the season.
Was the Necrodancer splash screen up on the lobby for Amok? Did you see that? Or was it just stream loading shenanigan?
I'm not sure. I was looking away, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's really strange. They might have been tabbed out or something. I don't know.
Maybe. There are some weird splash screens things.
Alright, Chill Reeve saw it too, yeah. I've seen that with Level Editor. Like, if you do a boss in Level Editor and beat it and reset on the splash screen, you go back into Level Editor with the splash screen up, and then it generates a level of, like, the next zone from the boss that you cleared. It's incredibly bizarre.
That's strange.
Yeah, I found that the other day, and then I think either Jack or Greamy was like, oh yeah, I've known about that for a year.
There are so many just, like, legacy bugs.
Yeah.
Plectro stream really behind?
Very behind for me. Yeah.
Yeah, which it was fine before. There wasn't.
Try a refresh.
Yeah. Let me see.
Oh, yeah. Refreshing helps it a lot.
Cool. Let me sort that for you guys.
And Amok taking a few hits here. You really don't want to, you know. It goes without saying that you don't want to have that in Zone 1, especially before seeing your blood shop. It just limits the decisions you can make there.
Yeah, and I'll be honest, in Blood Tier, if you're taking big hits early, reset. Just reset.
Yeah, I think that's right. These races aren't at that bleeding edge of speed where you cannot afford that time.
Exactly, you know, you're not costing yourself a race just because you reset because you took a big bit of damage early.
You know, that race was pretty close. That last one was pretty close, guys.
Alright, so both of her, which is, I mean, I haven't seen heart transplant, like, actively used for the longest time. And then we had one in a previous race from Grimmy. And then seeing both Plectro and Amok using that heart transplant here. Amok electing to use his last bomb to take out that Direbat, which I don't agree with. Direbats are generally pretty simple to deal with. I think using your bomb on that, it's a bit of a waste.
Plectro, like, you went... Okay, alright, you are going back to or something. I think the armor is fine. I think you can go for armor or weapon or traveler ring here and be justified.
Yeah. It's nice to kind of have your armor done and dusted out of the way early.
Yeah, the only reason why you would think about not doing it is just be like it being. Are they on 1-2 or 1-3? I can't tell. Like, you know, it's still zone one, and you're not going to get, you know, your heavy plate conjure at, most likely. Okay, so they were on 1-3. These guys are, again, just dead even. But Plectro has the throwable and the bomb, and so they're gaining just a ton of time.
Yeah,
fortunately, gets them a titanium spear, but...
Yeah, not the fastest weapon in the world, but, you know, it's useful enough. You're doubling your damage, you've got that 2 range. It's comfortable, especially through Zone 2. And again, I've spoken about it for quite a while since the DLC has come out. There are so many more damage up items now.
And Plectro, use the Pain Shrine.
You want him to use it?
Yeah, well, he has cheese, and...
That's a good point with the cheese, yeah. I imagine maybe...
There's a spirit! Do it there! Okay, perfect. Although, Snowbro.
Okay, there we go. Alright, so gets the chicken... Oh, that's beautiful. Doesn't have the bomb for courage,
that's
unfortunately.
An absolute crap Pain Shrine, though. You got nothing. You got a base whip, base spear, a base longsword, and a gi. Like, that's garbage.
And a chicken, though.
Okay, and a chicken, sure. But he's at less health now with a chicken than he was before with the cheese.
Yeah, really not what you want.
Oh, man, that's so bad. That should get, like...
The pills for, like, Shrine of Pain and stuff, they just need tweaked.
Boost. Well, it just needs to get any chest plus whatever.
Yeah.
Right? Because it's probably just any chest of this floor.
Yes.
And I get why you want it to be weaker, because you can get friggin' 5 items. Like, that's incredible, but...
You're having to give up health.
You're giving up health, and
it's like a ton
of time. You know, waiting for something to smack you that many times is a big time loss. And when it can just be base whip, and, like, that just stinks.
Exactly. And yeah, like Ink says, it is actually possible that's plus one, but that's got to be plus zero, surely. It would be heartbreaking for that to be plus one.
Yeah, that would just be incredibly terrible luck. Now, I don't know if you go for this obsidian spear as a mock. I think you probably just stick with your old faithful and go for weapon on the boss.
Yeah, that's probably the play to do. I feel like a match.
Obsidian spear is just like not a big upgrade.
Yeah, it's not a big upgrade. You have the concern that, you know, you're going to be dropping your beat a fair amount. And that's the other key thing to bear in mind. So just keep your solid 2 damage, and keep on trucking. And then ideally hope for Ring of War or Ring of Might. Get yourself up to the 3. Can you get another Ring of Wonder? That'd be fine.
Field spell's pretty good.
Yeah, gonna do a lot of use in bailing out. Plectro will need to see whether a Mac is going to pick that up as well.
I think the big thing that, like, you see with... In terms of, like, getting a build together, in terms of that decision-making level, it's just, like, doing things on the wrong floors. For guys at this tier versus guys at Obsidian or Crystal.
Yeah.
Because you'll see, like, you know, like, in our Obsidian promotion races earlier, like... One, they were faster getting here, but they were faster while getting better things, right? And that's like shopping on X3 versus X1. You know,
yeah,
like,
exactly.
Plectro is shopping on 3-1 right now, and you know, got okay stuff, but not
exactly
not incredible. Or
got the Ring of War that a Mac wants, basically, but a Mac's not going to get.
Yeah, the chainmail is good. Plectro almost eating that fireball. It looked like a late beat thing, trying to think about how do I avoid this.
It looked like for a second he was like, oh, I can get my leopard. Oh, no, wait. Already got his lucky charm.
I already have that. Yeah. I don't know what was... Yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
No, and you go, and you go.
I don't know what was spooking Plector in that exit room. Like, he took the time as if something was scary, and it's probably that Yeti.
Yeah.
But, you know, you can make that. Like, that's not that... Oh, you got a bomb through, I think. Oh, you only have one bomb. I guess not.
Yeah, dig your way through.
This is
and
such
then
a good
go
layout for it.
Oh, taking a hit there from a Yeti. Does have plenty of health and that chainmail in tow.
You get miners. No, you just get a good shovel, I guess. You know, that's good, because Shrine of Space is not going to... Like, that's just a shovel container where it is in the run.
Yes. At this, like, you're not... Even at higher tiers,
now,
that's not... Like, you're not going for cap there, I don't think.
I didn't realize Plector had killed their mini-boss. But they spent, like, 30 or 40 beats having killed it without jumping in that trapdoor.
Yeah.
You gotta...
Just pop your shield spell and jump down the trapdoor.
Yeah. They wanted to check the red chest, which, you know... But after that, then they went all the way to the exit rather than the trapdoor. And it's like, if you don't have a mini-boss, there's no reason not to take it. Unless the exit is, you know, just right there.
Yeah. Don't take courage. No, 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 no. You go back and you pick up that Ring of War. That is... It's just not the right decision. I'm going to straight up say it. That's not the right decision. You're going to be dropping your beat. You're way better off with that Ring of War. You don't need courage either. Again, it's not going to be a difference maker. I mean, well, it might be a difference maker now in that he might find himself possibly falling behind a bit more because you're going to be spooked.
The kind of difference you want.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Like, if that was still old courage, absolutely.
Yeah,
I have
sure.
no issues with it. But it's not. It's new courage.
Oh man, this is spooky.
This is the worst. I hate nightmares.
Alright, well handled. Like, yeah, Plector does very well with these, like, finishing, like, just clearing enemy patterns. Especially, like, for, you know, this like, area of blood that they're in. Like, this is really good play. I just want the decision making to, you know.
Yeah, like, I mean, like you said, fair credit to him. Plectro is playing this courage well, but I still don't think it's the right decision.
I think they want that dragon to
Ring of War.
Barrel,
see, Ring of War there, you no problem.
Yeah, they might have just thought they had it.
Exactly, that's the issue. You've been running that Ring of War for like a not insignificant amount of time as well, and like this is something that used to trip me up a lot. If I've been running a build for a while and then changed like one of the key components of it, I'd be kind of lost and confused. It's like, hang on, I thought I had. Oh no, wait. And that's the kind of thing that when you're in Blood Tier, you really need to be on top of your build.
Yeah, build awareness is an important thing.
Yeah.
You could see those telemonkey eyes coming at you. But it ended up not being too bad. Got transported over. It's not the very beginning of the level.
Yeah. The one thing I would say is Plectro, that conga fight for Plectro, there was a moment of genius using the Goblin Bomber to bomb conga off the throne. And then just a moment of not quite knowing courage interactions by hitting conga and then taking a hit from another enemy because they weren't protected. And that's just the kind of thing you got to be careful of. I imagine looking for a blast helm sometimes here, but never.
Yeah.
It's not coming.
This like this confusion and goo and like the... Yeah, I think the sunglasses take is good with this. having that plus one is very helpful.
Absolutely, yeah. That makes this courage a lot more viable now.
Plectra is kind of running away with this at this point.
Yeah, Max getting really hung up here in zone 4, unfortunately.
Yeah, it looks just like not comfort with goo and not comfort with Blade Masters and confusion.
Yeah. Basically all the nasty stuff in zone 4.
Yeah, right. All of the things that make zone 4 hard. That's one of the things I think you'll notice, like, actually as a big titanium to obsidian leap is
oh, Plectro, no! Down he goes to the red dragon, was just wailing on it, and there was a water tail, jumped in that and took another fireball to the face. He's going to be back to the start.
And just opens the door for a mock. It's 1-0, right? So this wouldn't...
Yeah, this would tie it up if a Mac can beat this run. But, oh, just... You just got to back off a bit there. You have a shield spell. Use your spells. I can hear Jack in the background actually screaming, use your spells.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Again, as we spoke about, build awareness is key.
Yeah, I think Pib is right, though. Like, this isn't a spell awareness problem. This is a not seeing danger problem. And that's kind of the issue. The thing is, though, like, a seeing danger and using spells, like, those are related issues.
Exactly.
Right? Because, like, a lot of the times when you are using spells, it's not because you, like, think, oh, I'm going to get hit. It's because this is the kind of situation in which I get hit.
Exactly. Right? Like, one of the key changes that I noticed myself do with spells was I went from using them, like, as a panic button to, like, cracking open a door, having a look and seeing what was inside, and just saying, screw this. No way.
Yeah.
Hit my spell, and then deal with it in a safe manner. That's the kind of criticism of, like, that play from Plectro, is that the shield spell should have been used way earlier.
Yep.
Because, like, from the point of him opening that door, that room looked like a bit of a mess. Because it was. There was a skull right at the door.
So, Amok just gave us a really good example. And I think they used it too early. But that was a case of, like, oh, man, I see these black skulls, I see these electromages, I see this dragon spell, right? And they weren't in any danger on the beat where they used it. But it was a, this situation is dangerous, so I'll use my spell. But I think Pib's point is fair, that the situation in which Plectro died is not necessarily this is a dangerous situation in which I should use shield. Now, Mach is making this spooky.
Yeah, this
They're
is...
gonna be.
I'm not sure what this Deadringer strat is. It's bad and off the rails.
So here's the problem when people have, like, Dead Ringer off the rails, is they just focus, like, they laser in on that middle column.
Yes.
And that means all the skeletons that are spawning, that are coming at them, are just seeking to the middle column. And, like, by the time they have the charge set up, there's a skeleton blocking it again. I think you have to, at a certain point, get them seeking a different row. And that usually means timing, like, when they're getting to the row next to it. You know, the ones right off center.
Mm-hmm.
And getting them aggroed in that. So we have a 1.5 heart Necrodancer fight.
Yeah, which is... It's kind of spooky. It'll make that 1 heart, unfortunately.
Yep.
Taking another hit there, so...
So I think, it'll probably be... Like, it'll probably mean you can take... one more hit and then
not gonna the do the shield glitch. All right, okay.
I think a lot of blood people just don't know about it because a ton don't use it.
That's got to be in the racing guide, surely.
I would assume so, yeah.
Yeah, like, and it's one of these things that you see often enough as well in races. Like, oh, everyone seems to be popping their shield spell when they just before the Necrodancer jumps off the stage. What's up with that?
Yeah. We are in the weird situation right now of the only things left on the stage are the turnips.
Yes.
Which is like the absolute opposite from what it normally is.
Yeah, it's
so
a
I'm
weird
enjoying
one.
That part of all this.
It's an interesting aesthetic choice.
This is where you hate sunglasses, right? Because you're like, is that Shield Skelly one that I can jump into or not?
Absolutely not in this case. Amak
is
going to be real careful.
This is really
he's getting surrounded.
He's hit with Dorian. Okay, this is half heart. All right.
Half heart Cadence, heart and a half Dorian. We are officially in Spooksville. And gets the final hit.
This is it.
Right.
Pulls it out. That was scary.
Yeah,
I don't want to be that scared again.
By the skin of his teeth, Mac manages to pull off the victory there, and ties this race at one game apiece.
Oof. I feel like Dead Ringer and Necrodancer were the past like 5 minutes of that run.
I'm emotionally drained.
Yeah.
Yeah, someone needs to sit a Mac down and be like, okay, here's how you lure. Never do anything else.
Yeah.
Like,
and that's really,
I hate that I shared it so often because I sound like a broken record, but please, for the love of God, learn Deadringer. It's not difficult. It's nowhere near as difficult as a lot of people make it out to be. It can be. It can go off the rails and it can be a nightmare, right? But it's if you're doing
like
the strats...
The spawns can make it really nasty.
Yeah. But if you're doing strats, you're vastly reducing the risk of it going off the rails, especially if you lure.
I think it's just kind of like people just... Like, if it's just boring to sit and drill a boss. But, like, it's one of the most, like... The easiest and quickest ways to get better race times. Drill Deadringer.
Exactly. Just stop spending an extra 30 to 60 seconds on Deadringer because it went off the rails.
It's a ton of time that you lose when they go wrong.
Exactly. It's very rare that we see Deadringer go off the rails and someone gets it back on like in an efficient manner. It just generally doesn't happen.
You see it. Well, you see Crystal and Obsidian guys get it back on the rails pretty easily, but that's because they've put in the time.
Exactly.
Right? They've like known. Okay, if this happens, I go up the second column for a little bit, and then I can switch back to the center column, and it'll be fine.
Yeah, exactly. They have experience with the boss, and I mean a lot of the those upper tier racers. I imagine they themselves haven't. Sat down in the boss practice and done a huge amount of it. You know, there will be a chunk of them that just haven't done that much practice sat down.
Right.
But over time, you learn it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But I think it's quicker to do, like, to drill.
Yeah, to just sit down and go into the boss.
We've got a pause on Plectro's side, and I don't know why. Emoji. Okay, I guess we're pausing. Hopefully they'll explain what. Pause. This is not CondorBot. Oh, crap.
It should do that. It should work.
No, restarting the game. Dude, we're in a race. Like, you can, but, like, you're giving up the, you know. I think they already did.
Yeah. Guys, never just reset your game. Ever.
Well, if you're not in a race, fine.
Yeah, like, okay, that's fine. But if you're mid-race, then, await further instruction from the staff.
Don't just do stuff, right? Like,
We've had this a couple of times. Generally, most of you guys have been totally fine. And, looks like Stream Down as well.
Maybe they're just restarting everything.
arcade. So yeah. Even more so, never drop your stream without letting us know.
Yeah, and Plector is saying, you know, tons of processor used and game was laggy and stuff, but like, we're in a race. You are on cast in front of 200 people. If you just take your stream down and do that stuff, nobody has any idea what's going on. You've got a, you know, you're in a tournament, you're in a structured format. We need more communication.
Exactly. So yeah, word of advice to anyone showcase, if you run into these issues, it's fine, just alert the staff, ask for a pause, explain the situation, and we can discuss together how to go forward.
It'll take an extra 10 seconds, but
exactly,
we'll get it actually resolved properly. Alright, is the stream back up?
It doesn't look like it yet.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the voice in my headphones is Polish right now again. I've heard a little bit of Polish from Chicago. I should probably not phrase it as the voice in my headphones, because
that sounds a little bit like you're gonna get carted off somewhere.
Yeah, no, it's just these weird radio signals. Oh yeah. God, this makes it sound even worse. I'm just going on and on.
Will's never been this quite the same since he moved out west.
Yeah.
But yeah, sorry about the delay, guys. A couple of issues for Plectro, game running really low FPS and stuff.
Yep.
Is there like a significant Polish contingent in LA? It's not something like I don't really know.
Not in LA. Yeah, that's why it's confusing that there'd be a radio station.
Yeah.
All right, I see Plector stream up. In Chicago, there's a huge Polish community.
All right, okay, interesting. Because there's a really big Polish community in Edinburgh.
Oh, huh. Yeah, I've heard Chicago is like the second biggest Polish community outside of Poland. Like, and including ahead of a bunch of cities in Poland. Dang it, Space Cow. Okay, yeah. He's using the website to, yeah, that's probably it. Yeah, honestly, I think the, like, don't screen watch thing only works for, like, I think it works in two places. It works for Mudjo, and it works in Blood Races. I don't think you need to, I just don't think you need to screen watch at this race. No? I mean, you want to know when somebody died. But, like, yeah, you can get it through this cast, or, you know, like, so when I still did actual racing, I would often not screen watch, and I would just have the commentary of whatever thing, which, you know, is delayed, but like, that big a deal. Because this is so and I know that people, like, you're better off getting practice screen watching and doing it well, especially with our RTMP system.
For sure.
But there's, like, I think there's something to be said for, like, it's really distracting, you know?
Exactly. Yeah. Like, this has kind of been
get you killed.
Like, you're like, I am the guy that pushed for RTMP to be used and set up, and, you know, like, I love the system to bits, but, like, there is a point when you're learning to race this game where you got to be like, all right, I need to focus on just what I'm doing. And I would say that basically applies, like, almost across the board blood tier. At the start of the season, the upper blood tier racers, I could totally understand them screen watching, because they were, you know, they're a higher caliber than what's currently in blood tier, just with the way that this system works.
Yep.
But at this point,
although it's kind of weird since we get more, like, people join that are good, you know?
This is true.
Sorry, anyway, continue the point.
But yeah, like, once you get to, like, this point in the season, really, you gotta just focus on doing your own thing, because it's not quite as... It's not so much, like, I'm not gonna say it's not a serious race. It is a serious race. You are racing head-to-head, but a lot of it is more about, can I finish this run, than can I outspeed my opponent and have better decisions than my opponent. Like, a lot of the information that you're going to be getting from screen watching is just going to be totally superfluous when you're racing at this level.
All right, I think we're off again finally.
Yes.
So Plectro lost about a minute of progress because he restarted his game. We did, you know, and normally in that type of situation, if somebody crashed or whatever, we would, we'd start both racers over on a new seed, but Plectro just decided to close his game. So it wasn't a staff decision to, do that. So, just treating it as a death.
Yeah.
If you unilaterally close your game, you do not get to make your opponent restart by doing that.
Yeah, exactly. It's just not something that we can or will do.
The mock finding lead boots, which is, you know, not too bad. Bomb, also not too bad. That shop on Plectro's side is pretty nice if you can do something about it.
Yeah, I'm trying to see... I mean, if he finds a wall torch in a nice position... Well, there's one there. But I'm not sure if you could throw his dagger and then lure him out.
He doesn't have Infernal.
No, but there's Infernal in the shop. You can buy that in the shop.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sorry. I was only paying attention to the chain.
You're only paying attention to the good items in the shop. That's fair.
Yeah. Well, it's
Infernal.
Not bad.
Infernal has uses. Yeah,
it's fine.
Yeah.
It adds, like, it's very good for figuring out kind of crazy shopkeep kills when you have ways of digging shop walls.
Yeah.
Without having bombs.
Yeah, plenty of wacky stuff that you can do with the Infernal Torch. Plectro, you... Oh, no, he doesn't have the Obsidian Spear. Sorry, it's a Mac that has the Obsidian Spear. Alright, It's like, why is he not breaking up in the crate? He should go back and break up in the crate now.
That's a long way back. I think that's not that far back. I think that's too much even for a Blood Promotion race. I mean, these guys have been finishing... You know, if Plectro hadn't died on the last race, it would have been a 12-minute finish or something. Like,
yeah, that's,
you know,
fair.
You can't throw away 30 seconds in when that's the margin.
That's fair. He's going to take a big hit here. So losing this multiplier, so this dragon kill is going to be slow. And having to make use of that apple.
Yeah, although he could have saved it, and I think at a higher level you probably do. Because you have that regen.
Yeah.
You know, you don't expect to be taking damage on your zone 1 boss. So you'll get two regens out of it. Although, as I say that, I apparently curse Plectro. And you had the 3 damage before killing the pawns. That is a strat you have to know.
Yeah, you gotta know when you can throw in Deep Blues. It's just... It saves you so much time. And sometimes you will just get yourself into a tangled mess with that chessboard. It can be confusing. Like, even at higher tiers, we do...
Yeah.
It's pretty rare, but we do see higher tier racers taking the odd hit on Deep Blues.
Usually when trying a quick kill, that is not the correct quick
yes.
kill for their weapon. But, you know, occasionally, otherwise... It's not, you know, it's not Death Metal 1 or anything, but
exactly.
It'll still get you.
All right, that's a really nice find for a Mac in that crate. Ring of Might, so +1 damage.
Ooh, and a monstrous shop.
Yep, very...
the last teleport was a little spooky, but do you take any of that? I don't think I take any of that.
No, I think it's fine to leave that behind. That monocle's going to be doing you a lot of good, as nice as it would be to have that half heart.
I think you can make the argument for the Explorer's Boots, but it's pretty much just a wash.
That's a 2-3 shop as well, and it was that bad.
Yeah.
Yikes.
Yeah. Single yike.
A single yike screamed into the abyss.
Yeah, I guess Jack's right. You can make an argument for Blood Longsword with the Ring of Might.
That's okay. Yeah, I don't mind that.
But, you know, this isn't the kind of build that you do that with, I think. Like, you do that when you have chainmail and, you know, as I say that, he gets plate. Yeah, it just doesn't feel like the right fit. I have a mock. Okay. Oh, I see.
Yeah, Plectro is just a slight show currently.
Oh, yeah, as you mention it, yes, it is very bad. Oh, two pauses in one race. Yeah, Plectro is totally frozen for a while there. I'm slightly worried that he's not pausing.
Yeah.
Although I can't tell if it's just his stream being very behind.
I have his stream back up and running, and he is not paused. So give us a second here, guys. Sorry.
Jeez.
I need to make some kind of technical difficulty screen.
If he doesn't see this in another minute, I think we take this race off cast, maybe.
Yeah.